What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Good evening. I want to welcome you back to the one and only Kiss God Radio right here on loveradionetwork.com. Love is where it's at. Y'all, I'm Pastor P, and you are definitely in the place to be tonight. I'm telling you, tonight, I got something special for you. I'm telling you, so you want to go ahead and let somebody know that Love Radio Network is on tonight, and Kiss God Radio is going to give it to you just like you like it. So come on and sit back, relax, go ahead and text somebody, call somebody, let them know it's on, and it's going to pop like popcorn. So let's do this tonight. Let's do it right. I pray that you had a wonderful day today. I pray that you let God in so he can put you on the right path where we pursue all things heavenly. I want you to join me every Tuesday morning at 6 a.m. for The Path, where God leads us and he guides us and we allow him to teach us on how to start our day, putting us on the right path. I want you to dial in to 301-202-1110. No, it's 302, right? I think it's 302. I'm sorry, 302. 202-1110. And the code is 705-257. They're going to get me if that's wrong. But hey, y'all can call the church office and get that right. All right, but I think it's 302-202-1110. Let me tell you something. I am down to make sure, because I be doing so much. I'm going to call my sister. No, I'm not. I'm not going to call my sister. Yeah, that's what it is. It's 302-202-1110. So I want you to do that on Tuesday morning at 6 a.m. for The Path. I dial so many numbers, y'all. And the code is 705-257. 705-257. Once again, The Path, Tuesday morning, every Tuesday morning at 6 a.m. Let me dive into this message before they kill me. Hey, y'all, listen. Did y'all hear about that man who won $10 million? $10 million in the lottery, $10 million, and got sentenced to life. $10 million he won. And then that same week or the week after, he got sentenced to life. I believe in 2017, they say he shot his girlfriend. And he's 54 years old, and I believe she was in her 20s. Unbelievable. $10 million you win in the lottery, and you're going to jail for life. Your life will take a serious turn, and also your sins will find you. But he confessed, and there it is. And where that money is going to go, maybe back in the pot. Or maybe in his children's pot get or someone else, but whatever. But that's crazy, right? That's people, I'm telling you. Hey, let's just live right. That's all. Let's just live right. If you're going to play the lottery, live right. Father, we thank you right now for this time, for your love, your grace, and your mercy. We appreciate your love. We appreciate laughter. We appreciate joy and your peace. Bless this evening tonight as I teach this message, that we may not get off this platform the same way that we got on, but with more of you and less of ourselves. In Jesus' matchless name, we do pray. Amen. All right, people of God, I want to jump directly in. I was doing some studying today, and you know, something just really popped in my mind, a term that I have been hearing lately, and it has been on, I've heard news commentators use it, I've heard it in movies, and then I began to research it, follow it, and even in psychology, we use it a lot now, and I'm like, okay, that's pretty interesting. Let me see how I can use this in Kiss God. So I think it's important to us all, but definitely in the life of singles, while you are dating, while you're trying to figure out relationships. But again, husbands and wives, and you know, go through this as well. Relationships, parents and children. So this, what I'm going to teach tonight, is definitely used in relationships, period. But let me take you to the Word of God first. I want to take you to 2 Corinthians, the 2nd chapter, the 11th verse. 2 Corinthians, the 2nd chapter, the 11th verse. Here begins God's word, and it says, "Lest Satan should take advantage of you, for we are not ignorant of his devices." So far the text. The word of the Lord has been spoken. The word of the Lord has been heard. Lest Satan should take advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. Now, tonight, y'all, is just one word that, if you've seen it on Facebook, I posted it late, but so it's all right. It's all good. Gaslighting. Now, I'm sure you heard the word before. I'm sure you might even know what it means, but I'm going to just kind of throw it out there, maybe to people that don't know about it. But the word gaslighting, or the term gaslighting, it's really a word that it describes a abusive behavior, right? Specifically when an abuser manipulates information in such a way to make a victim, or the person, I don't want to use victim, that seems so harsh, but the person question his or her sanity or their reality. I'm going to say it again. It's really a manipulative, manipulated behavior, information, in such a way that the person is making another person question his or her sanity or reality. Now, I realize that, and you can look all of this up, and there's books out there, you can Google it, so nothing that I'm saying is new. Okay, so this is not anything that I made up. This is just something that I believe a lot of people are dealing with, and they don't know it. They do not know it. They are in relationships. They are in marriages. They are dating. They have been with people for years, or just met a person, and the person is gaslighting them. And I want to put a stop to it. I literally want to put a stop to it. Now, it came about in 1938, 1944, around that time. And it was a movie called Gaslight. And what happens in the movie called Gaslight, 1944, yes, 1944, the husband uses trickery to convince his wife that she is mentally unwell, so he can steal from her. Boom. Isn't that crazy? Right? The husband. And it's really making me want to go see the movie or pull it up. I'm really going to try to pull this movie up. I don't know if it's on Netflix or what. Charlie Rock, we should really try to find it. But I don't know the content of you know, how it really is. But I'm going to check it out. But again, the husband uses trickery to convince his wife that she is mentally unwell so he can steal from her. That's a Selah moment. Stop, pause, think about it. Right? Stop, pause, think about it. The purpose of gaslighting is to get something from you. It's to steal something from you. And I don't care what it is. Your peace, your sanity, right? Finance, money, your body, right? For sex. I'm going to get something from you. I'm going to trick you. So you know what I'm thinking right now, y'all, to be honest, let's go back to the beginning of time. Did Satan use gaslighting to get to Eve. He manipulated her, tricked her, right? To make her, watch this, because gaslighting is, you start to question your reality. You begin to question who you are. And that's what Satan did. Eve started questioning. Yeah, maybe. Maybe I can be like God. Maybe I can touch the tree. Maybe I can take the fruit. Maybe I can. And that's what Satan does to people in reality, in today's time, in relationships. He manipulates you. Before you got into the relationship, before you got into the marriage, and even during the time where you seem to be okay, you seem to be whole with yourself, before you came into that relationship with that guy that you started dating, with that girl you started dating, you was whole, you was one with God. You felt the joy. You felt peace. You just felt good about yourself. Now, all of a sudden, in conversation, in communication, there are words that are used, and again, and again, and again, and again. Listen. There's abusive behavior, right? In words. This is what Satan used. He used words. This is why the Bible says here in 2 Corinthians that we should not be ignorant of Satan's devices. And I'm going to give you some things that I want you to be aware of tonight, right? Do not be ignorant of Satan's devices. He's smooth. He knows how to do it, knows how to get away with it, knows how to trick you into questioning who you are. Oh, we're not going to allow that. We're not going to allow that. I'm not going to do it. They're not going to do it to you. She's not going to do it to you. He's not going to do it to you. Why? Because tonight is an eye opener. So again, you can look up, you can look this up anywhere, you know, and find it, read it, books, because I'm pulling resources from different places right now. So again, gaslighting is a form of manipulation, right? That it often occurs in abusive relationships. And sometimes you don't even know you're in an abusive relationship. It is a covert type of emotional abuse where the bully, can I say that? All right. Yeah, right. Where the bully or an abuser misleads the target, creating a false narrative and making them question their judgment and reality. And boom, he got you. Gotcha. Ultimately here, the victim of the gaslighting starts to feel unsure about their perception of their own world. You was doing perfectly fine until this person started saying certain things to you, about you. Now you're questioning yourself. And you even begin to wonder if what I was believing about myself was true. This is what it is. And listen, Linda. Gaslighting primarily occurs in romantic relationships. But it's not uncommon now for it to occur in controlling friendships or among family members as well. That's why I said husband and wife, parent, children relationship, you know, watch this, pastor and parishioner. How about that? Yeah. I mean, gaslighting is real. Now, we're not just going to use the word. We're going to understand the word, right? We're going to have our eyes open to this, because this here, my brother and sister, is really, you know, this is really how it is. You know, back in the days, because I'm going to give you some terms that I will deal with today or I'll deal with next week. But remember back in the days, because, you know, God is opening up our eyes now in relationships, because relationships, I'm serious. They could take you up or they could take you down. They can make you feel good. They can make you feel bad. They can make you feel happy. They can make you feel sad. That's too much control. No, I'm serious. That is too much control that I'm in a relationship and I have to continue to be like, you controlling how I feel. No way now. Come on. Enough control. So here, back in the days, y'all remember we used to play, what was it called? Red light, 1, 2, 3. Was it red light, 1, 2, 3? Was it red light, green light? Was it red light, green light, 1, 2, 3? Oh, I'm bugging right now. Was it red light, green light? Was it red light? Y'all remember that? Did I just play it in the Bronx or did y'all play it in New Jersey or wherever you from? What was that? Red light, green light. I got to look it up. I'm sorry, y'all. I have to look this up because this is going to drive me crazy. Red light, green light, 1, 2, 3. That's it. One person is chosen to be it. That's it. That's what I'm looking for. The traffic light. One person is a traffic light. 5 meters away with his back towards the other people. The other players stand face in line. When his green light is called, the other players move forward until he spins around and calls red light. And if you're moving, y'all know it. If you move, he caught you. Yeah, you can't move with the red light. I'm going to talk about those. I'm going to talk about the red light, green light, 1, 2, 3. But I'm going to insert the yellow light. Okay, I'm going to insert the yellow. So we're going to talk about the red. We're going to talk about the yellow. We're going to talk about the green. Okay, I got to get to that. But here's some things that you really understand. That, again, you're second guessing yourself. You're second guessing yourself about your memories, your recent events, your perception. And then after communicating with the person that gaslighted you, you feel kind of dazed, you know, wondering if there's something is wrong with you. Boom. I'm raising my hand, like my right hand, left hand and 2 feet. You know, I feel like, what the world is wrong with you, man? I mean, you know, after the conversation, I felt like something's wrong. Something's not right. Something wrong with me. And then you may be encouraged to think that you're actually to blame for something, or that you're just being too sensitive. You're just too sensitive. Maybe I am. All right. That's how it works. That's how it works. And that's how they start getting to you, and it gets into your head. Y'all stay with me here. Stay with me. Charlie, you're right. We're going to go to 9 o'clock. All right. No. I'm just kidding. Y'all stay tuned for the bridge. So what happened is this, you know, people who are really engaging in gaslighting are often, listen to this, habitual and pathological liars. But you don't know it. They are exhibiting narcissistic tendencies. Yeah. Yeah. And it's typical for them to lie and never back down or change their stories, even when you call them out or provide proof of their deception. And they may say something like, "You're making things up. That never happened. You're crazy." Listen to me, ladies, gentlemen. In a relationship, you're dating, you don't really know him, or you've been in it, and for years you've been trying to figure this out. What is wrong? Something is wrong, and you're trying to figure it out here, right? No, is anybody with me here? So lying and distortion are really the cornerstones of gaslighting behavior. Now, again, y'all can just read this for yourself. I'm just trying to tell you, because you need to pump your brakes. Somebody needs to pump their brakes tonight, and they need to say, that's what it is. I just didn't know what it is, but that's what it is. And even when you know they're not telling the truth, they can be very convincing. What I'm trying to tell you, very, very, very convincing. And the end, you start to second guess yourself. Maybe they are right. They're good. Now, let me tell you something. Gaslighting takes skills. It takes skills to gaslight somebody. It's a form of manipulation. Y'all be careful out there. business, I don't care. Church, I don't care. Family, I don't care. Children, I don't care what it is. Be careful, right? And just real quick, I don't know how much time I have, but I'm starting to really get into it. But I might not be able to go to red light, green light, 1, 2, 3 until next week. Maybe we'll call it that next week, but I'm just trying to help you out. But they start discrediting you, right? They start discrediting you, and people who gaslight, they spread rumors and gossip about you to others, right? And they may pretend to be worried about you while subtly telling others that you seem emotionally unstable. Yo, she's crazy, man. She bugging. You know what she did the other night? I don't know why she's tripping. You know, they start saying stuff like that. Or, you know what? He's accusing me. He's accusing me of doing certain things when I'm not doing it. I know when God knows it. It's funny when they be putting God in there, right? I put my hand on the Bible. Now I put my hand on the Bible, and you know, I put, and I'm telling you, you don't want me to do that. I put my hand on the Bible. You know, for God, you ain't have to do that. You don't have to do that. Just stop. Let's just don't do that now. I believe you. Manipulation. I'm telling you, check it out. So this tactic is extremely, extremely effective. And many people side. They side. Don't you do it. Don't you side with the abuser. Don't you side with the abuser or the bully without knowing the full story. Oh, y'all, come on. Somebody talk back to me. So they discredit you. They distract you. I'm going to have to go next week, y'all. I'm going to have to pick this up next week. This is so good. You want to invite like 1,000 people next week. You want to invite like all your 1,000 followers. Tell them, look, you got to go to loveradionetwork.com and join us on Kiss God Radio, because this is good. Right. So even though you can get it from other places, you know, Pastor P is always going to add and I'm going to elaborate. Right. So come on, join us. So what did I say? So they discredit you, they distract you. So when you're asking someone who gaslights, you know, a question or call them out for something, you know, they did, you know, they start to say certain things like, where you get that from? Oh my God. They changed the subject by asking questions instead of responding to the issue. And this not only throws off your train of thought, but causes you to question the need to press the matter. Like maybe again, all right, let's just forget about it. We're supposed to go out for dinner tonight, and I don't want to mess up this night. You know, I want to come back home and just chill out with you. And then let me tell you something. Why? Oh, this is so good. Let me tell you why this really gets people. It's because they're falling in love. They're really emotional. That's why gaslighting gets to the emotions. Gaslighting gets to the emotions. God help me. My God. If my wife is listening tonight, we should have did this. We should have did our lit review on gaslighting. We would have really blew professor's mind. But listen. I'm telling you now. That they cause you to feel that the subject is unnecessary, so they're distracting you. And then what they do, the next thing, what time is it? God, man, they minimize your thoughts and your feelings. Like your feelings don't matter. You know that, like like they trivial. You know, your emotions allows the person who is gaslighting you to gain power over you. You know, they start making statements like, calm down, you're overreacting. Why are you so sensitive? Manipulation, getting into the mind. Y'all, I'm trying to help you. You kidding me? You kidding? Don't tell me that you haven't heard nobody say that to you before. Yeah, you have. Don't, and all these statements minimize how you're feeling or what you're thinking and communicating. And you're saying, maybe I'm saying something wrong. Maybe it's me. So when you deal with someone who never acknowledges your thoughts, who never acknowledges your feelings, who never acknowledges your belief, you begin to question them yourself. What's more? What's happening? What's going on? You know, before you felt like validated, right? Before you felt understood. But now you feel ashamed. Now things just seem difficult in your mind. And now you feel like isolating yourself. See, now you don't want to go out. Now you don't want to do. But the abuser got you. And now he's going to steal from you. See, he knows when you're not home. He knows where you are. He knows what you're doing. He knows when you're going to shut down because you just want to get under the covers and you just want to lay down. You don't want to deal with nobody because now you're feeling bad. He knows it. You know why? Here's the next one. He's shifting blame. I don't have time. I don't have time. Shifting the blame. It's a very common one for gaslighting tactic. I haven't even gotten into the crux of my message, but I can't, right? Because the bridge, y'all, the bridge is coming on 8:30. Dr. Charles Dean, y'all, is about to go down. Listen, every discussion you have is somehow twisted. Every discussion, shifting the blame, it's twisted to where you are the blame for something that occurred. And even when you try to discuss how the abuser's behavior makes you feel, they're able to twist it, able to twist the conversation so that you end up questioning if you're really the cause of their bad behavior. Are you with me? Of their bad behavior. They start to claim that if you only would behave differently, then they would treat you better. Y'all, that's gaslighting for you. That's gaslighting. Y'all, let's be aware. The only way that we can make changes is by being aware. This is how we stay on the right path, because God opens up our hearts and our minds and the Holy Spirit begins to teach us. Y'all, I'm Pastor P, and I'm thanking you for rocking with me for the next 30 minutes. I want you to come back next week on loveradionetwork.com. Love is where it's at. I want you to join us. Stay connected with us, and we appreciate you more and more. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. I pray that you go in peace, and may your peace be multiplied. Jolly Rock, take us to the bridge.
This song is dedicated to special, unique people like me. Outcast, but you're never cast out.
Loving what I see when the mirror looks at me, 'cause I imagine me in a place with no insecurities, and I'm finally happy, 'cause I imagine me letting go of all of the ones who hurt me, 'cause they never did deserve me. Can you imagine me saying no to thoughts that try to control me, remembering all you told me? Lord, can you imagine me? Oh, the one that my mom said, heal from what my daddy did. I wanna live and not breathe that page again. Oh, imagine me being free, trusting you totally. Break me down. You won't get the jaw this time around. Imagine me in a world where nobody has to live afraid, because of your love, fear's gone away. Can you imagine me living? my heart will dance, 'cause I don't have to read the page again. Ooh. Oh, I can see myself. Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. I used to beat myself up all the time. Always been strange, so I thought I'd never shine. Fighting to be accepted, always was rejected. But the Lord held me in his hand, kept me in his plan. I thought I would go astray, but he kept me by his grace. It's only by his grace that I'm standing here today. I can smile at you and say that I'm free, yeah, yeah, yeah. Or can you imagine?